So over here, first is what is a perimeter, right? So it refers to the length of the outline of the enclosed figure, right? So for example, this is a shape. Okay. In this, I have to do two things. One, I have to do fencing, right? And second, I have to plant the trees, right? So tell me where I will do fencing and where I will plant trees.
Fencing you have to do outside
In the boundary,
in
right?
the boundary. So we have to find the perimeter for that, and to plant trees we have to find the area.
Yes, because we will inside plant the tree, right? So for this we will find the area.
Area.
Okay? So now first thing is that, so perimeter, what is perimeter in case somebody asks you? It refers to the length of the outline of the enclosed figure, or instead of outline, you can write boundary. Okay? Boundary of the enclosed figure. It can be any figure, triangle, rectangle, anything. Right? Then area, it refers to the surface of the enclosed figure. Whatever surface they cover inside, that is known as area. Right? Then you will draw the diagram like this. This diagram, perimeter, perimeter, perimeter and area. Okay? Now, let's just do one. So, area and perimeter of square. So, what is square? Square is a quadrilateral with four equal sides, right? Then, what is the formula for area of a square? Ma'am, it is side multiply by side and perimeter 4 multiply by side, right? We will write all this and then you will do this question. Fine? Okay. You will write it down from here, right? Starting from here, and then you will do this question. Example, this question. Okay, so start writing first, and then once you are done, let me know. I will show you the question. You can do the answer, and you will tell me. Okay, I want the proper, like, I just want a proper answer. You can see this. For example, this is a question. So first, you will write perimeter of square, 4 multiply by side, then 4 multiply by 3, 12 centimeter. And if you have to find the area, then you will write area of square, S into S, or you will write the proper side multiply by side. Okay? Then 2 multiply by 2 and that's it. Fine? Remember one thing. Whenever you find area, right? At that time, it will be centimeter square, meter square, like this. But when you find perimeter, at that time, it's only centimeter, meter. Fine? So if you would, why in this you are doing this? Because 2 centimeters are coming and you are multiplying it. That's why it's a square. So if you don't write, for example, you find out the area and the area was 46 centimeter, but you didn't put square. So you will lose half marks here. Okay. You have in area always put square. Okay. And in perimeter, no need to write any square. Okay. You can start.
After some portion is omit for me.
Which one?
Ma'am, I don't have introduction squares and rectangles.
Okay.
Try these. Then I don't have page 206, 207, 208, 209. Then in page 210, I have Friday's omit to is nothing's omit.
Okay, so you don't have this rectangle and square?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So you have, I think, from triangles?
Yes, ma'am, and 225, 226, and 127, and 228 is omit at end.
Okay, so you would have, that we won't be doing it because we will be starting from here only, like, you know, this chapter. We will be starting from circles and parallelogram, don't worry. But I just wanted you to write the formula so that, you know, in future, if somebody asks you, then you have to tell them the answers, right? So you will only write the formula, no need to solve it. Okay? So just write the formula and then let me know, we will scroll, okay?
Hear me?
Yes, now I can hear you. Done? Okay. Now you will only write the formulas. You will write area and perimeter of rectangle. What is rectangle? A rectangle is a quadrilateral with equal opposite sides. Right? And then you will write area and perimeter. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
These two formulas. Okay. Now. Yes.
Start from area of parallelogram.
Yes, now we will start from there. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Now coming to parallelogram, what is parallelogram? So it is the simple quadrilateral with two pair of parallel side, right? And how do we write the parallelogram? We mention it like this. Instead of writing the entire spelling, you write parallel and GM, right? This is parallel and this is gram, right? So instead of this, you can write it like this. Area of parallelogram equals to base into height, fine? So this is basically the area of parallelogram, which is base into base multiplied by height, right? So this is, for example, a question is given. Solve this and find me the answer. Okay, write it from here. Fine?
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, I got the answer.
You got the answer?
Yes, ma'am. The answer is 48 centimeters square.
Yes. Now, area of triangle. So, what is a triangle? It is a three-side closed triangle. If we join two congruent triangles together, we get a parallelogram, right? So, that's why it is, it has two formula. First is half of area of parallelogram. So, what is the area of parallelogram? It is half into base into height. Base into height, right? Getting it, what I am trying to say? No?
Yes, ma'am, I got it.
Yes, so it's basically the parallelogram, right? Half of parallelogram. So what is the area of parallelogram? Area of parallelogram is base into height.
Base into height.
So you will do half.
Triangle is half of parallelogram, mm-hmm. So it's half into base into height.
So first you will write this, then I will give you one question to solve. Okay?
Okay.
This. Find this. Okay, what you got?
Centimeter square.
30.
Centimeter square.
Okay. Now coming to circles. Okay. So what is circle? First of all, circumference. Okay, so circumference. In the circle, you don't say perimeter, you say circumference, right? So, circumference refers to the distance around the circle. So, for example, if this is a circle, this area, this part is known as circumference. In circle, we have three things. One is the radius, one is the diameter, one is the pi, right? Radius is the straight line from the circumference till the center, from the circumference to the center, right? And diameter, it refers to a line from one point of the circumference, right, to the another point of the circumference passing through the center. Okay? And pi, it refers to the ratio of circumference to the diameter, right? There is a fixed value of pi, right? There are two values. One is 22 by 7 or 3.14. Clear? Yes? So, you will quickly write it down, and when they ask you the formula of circumference, you will write 2 pi r. Clear? Okay. And then if they ask you, this is the, then you will draw this diagram. This is the circumference. This is the diameter. This is the radius. And what is the pi? You have two value. One is 2 pi r and this. Okay. Then what is the a? Okay. Just do one thing. Just write this first and I'll tell you.
22.7 or 3.14 is the value of the pi, right?
Yes. You can take any. Most of the question, it will be given to you. But in most of the question, it won't be given to you. Right? At that time, I'll tell you which value you will choose. Okay?
Okay, ma'am. below 22 by 7 or 3.14, what did you write?
Oh no, this is nothing. You just write circumference and write 2 pi r. Okay?
Is my voice audible? Done,
Sorry.
ma'am.
Done? Okay. Now you will draw this diagram. Okay. No need to write this. No need to write anything. Just draw the diagram. Okay. Done. Okay, now this is the question, right? What is the circumference of the circle of diameter this and take pi this, fine?
Show me how to solve it.
Sorry.
Could show me how to solve it?
Okay. First, what is the formula for circumference? Tell me.
2 pi r.
So over here, do you have r?
A radius.
Is
yes,
given?
ma'am.
Where is the radius?
It's not given, but diameter, if you divide it by 2, then you'll get the radius.
Now you have everything put in the formula and get the answer.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah.